So, you lovely lot, we are on the new Little Babby mini feeder. Been fishing across for about half an hour or so, getting loads of little taps in that. Had a couple fall off, but I've had an instant win, so we should be in straight in the pub, actually, to be fair. But I've changed to a mini one, and instantly it's come round with like a dirty, great big £2 F1. So it's definitely making a difference. Just introducing that little bit less feed. Obviously, not as many options and not pulling as many fish in. And it's just come round straight away. I've changed the mix a little bit as well. I'm on half ground bait and half micros rather than pure micros. A little bit too rich that I think before. And it's just come really nice. These little babby mini method feeders. Let's get that over there, right into there. Sink that line. So I'm giving it sort of 3 minutes between casts. Obviously because there's not as much feed on it. If it was the small one that was on before. Yeah, there's a mini one. There's a small one. Small one on before, that was like 5 minute casts, a bit more feed. But with these 3 minute casts. See, I'm on, look at the tip already, Joe. It's going round already. Tap, 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 tap. So yeah, just not introducing as much feed. So perfect on days like this where the fish are that really hungry, coming to the bait as soon as you put it in. But obviously, you just don't want to introduce too much feed. That's my way of thinking anyway. So already that tip's going dip, 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 like that. I'm not going to give it too long. We've got what we've got on watch. We've got 2 minutes left on that. Go on, get in, zoom in on tip. Hey, up.
Casting nice and tight.
Of course, Joe. No, I wouldn't say fin-esque, but yeah, we're casting. Yeah, we're casting pretty tight. No, that's a liner. Surely that's a liner. That's a hell of a drive-by, isn't it? That's what you get like a great big catfish something swimming through, isn't it? But I don't think it's moved my feeder because it's settled back nice. So we've got 90 seconds left on that one. Yeah, no more than sort of like 10 or 12 inches off that. Sort of like Tina Turnip bushes, they call them. You know what I mean? With the spiky things. I'm not going to the peg, I'm going into a little bit of cover. But you see like the odd tail coming up and everything. It's right nice.
So I think a lot of people now associate that method fishing with like chucking it out and leaving it until you catch one.
Not a chance, Joe.
It's great
look.
For chucking against features and stuff, isn't it?
Oh, perfect. Yeah, especially when you hide your bait. So what we're doing, I'll show you next time when we come back. I'm putting a hard layer on first, and then I'm putting like a little softer layer on just to protect it should I go a little bit too far into the bushes. Just so it's protecting my hook bait. But then you get a little plop, and so we're not leaving it long. Got a watch on the go and everything. I reckon 50 seconds on that, I think.
So you're busy,
bring it back.
You're building.
It's brilliant. It's what I don't like, Joe, is just sitting there, you know, waiting for bites. I've got to be active. I've got to be doing something. And that's the beauty of this style of fishing. So you're always on the go. So it makes me wonder now with them few little taps I had first. They were, you know, obviously fish coming in and the pinched on my bait now. So there's nought left. There's no right and wrong with the hook baits, you know. Either folks, you know, use what you want. I love using Robin Reds though. I just love a 6mm Robin Red.
Just a great hook bait.
Oh, they're amazing. 14's MCM hook on, 4-inch, 0.19. Straight out of the pocket, here they are. There they are, the beauties. Look at them. Straight out. That's what we're on.
Is that where you're on that one?
Oh, okay. Now then. No, liner, so I'm going to bring that back now anyway. 3 minutes is up. 3 minutes is up.
What we got, a 10-foot rod?
10-foot monster rod. Oh, it might have been on. It's blooming big on me pellet. Hey, he might have been on him. So, straight on. Yeah, boy. But make sure it's flat around the middle. That's it, done, dusted. Right, so, let me show where we're loading this then. So, ground bait in first. Got a little press down. Hook bait, I like to put it right at the bottom here. Get a press down. Method goes over the top. Give it a nice press down. Eject it, and then I like to put a little babby soft one on there, you know what I mean? Just so you get that initial as it goes in the water. You know what I mean, Joe, don't you?
Exactly what you mean.
Do you actually? Yeah. I've just made that up.
I think it's good, that little.
Right, so that gets swung out like that. That goes in like that over there, and then that's where we are. A little bit. Oh, no, there's a swirl right off that, actually.
It is only shallow over there.
It's proper shallow over there. Yeah, I'd say we're a few inches away from where I wanted to be there, but Joe was in the way and we had one on anyway, so it doesn't really matter, does it? Well, that's that in one, and obviously you've seen there, don't worry about just getting your tip straight on the rest. You're still going to feel a bite if it happens. I reckon this is a skimmer, Joe. It might be another instant. Oh, no, it's not an instant. Instants don't bite. Lovely rods these, mate. Shocker. They're like feisty little things, aren't they, these swans? Come on then. But you saw how quick it can be, folks, you know what I mean? Yes! Oh, we missed him! Joe, we're not doing too well today, the old scoopy scoopage. It's because these feisty little things, isn't it? That's why. Little feisty swans. Let's get him unhooked. Beautiful then, though. 10 ounce? Pound. Let's get him in net. Let's load up again. So, bait's still... It's one I like to change my bait every time. Because, I don't know.
Bait, you mean?
I do. I love to change my upbait every time, Joe. I think it's got that fishy scent on it. I just want to be as fresh as possible every time. We'll get another one of them out.
So you're making sure you're doing everything right every time.
Well, I wouldn't say everything right. That cast wasn't right for a start.
It went round, didn't it?
It did go round, mate. It was a little babby one. We were a little bit shy where we wanted to be. But again, I'm blame you because you're in the way.
Okay. So obviously people probably see these mini feeders and think, well, it's just for winter, but it's not, is it?
Not a chance. So as I briefly touched upon before, it's perfect in situations where...
Like this, we catch them up.
You all know how much I love to feed, and obviously I was introducing too much feed with even the small feeder before, the small method. So by putting a little baby mini one on, it sorted it out. More regular chucks, though, rather than, say, leaving it a little bit longer, cast every sort of 2 or 3 minutes or something. The other thing that they're particularly good for is, I mean, the wind's died down a bit now, but if you had a short pole line in, you'd get like loads of lines and far lookers, and you couldn't really present it, putting one of these little bad boys on. It's perfect, because again, there's not loads of bait going in, but you're fishing straight on the bottom and you don't get any foul lookers or liners or anything like that. It's perfect for that. You know what I mean? Oh, I tell you what, little underarm, little babby. You know what I mean? Here we are.
It's lovely, isn't it? It's worth saying that
stop
fish
it.
Came straight away, didn't it?
Yeah, definitely. So we had that little swirl. We'll catch a quicker one now because that's where we need to be, Joe. A bit shy before. You're not in way, though, are you? You know what I mean? That was Finn, he'd be proud of that, wouldn't he?
Well, we'll find out, won't we, when he watches this video.
All right, he'll be proud of that. Be proud of that. So line sunk on the rest. Little babby, come on then. It's gotta go around. It's just got to go around.
You always sink your line, yeah?
I do. So obviously conditions like this where it's windy, I mean it's not overly heavy feed, it's 30 grams, so it's pretty heavy and it'll do the job, it'll stay there, but the slope, it seems pretty steep over there. And obviously if I was left my line floating, then the wind's going to obviously take my feeder out of position, so that's why we're sinking it straight away. Obviously you can put, you know, stuff on your line, treat your line, washing up liquor or anything like that. But yeah, you know, if you're getting them straight away and there's no wind or anything, it's flat calm or it's off your back or whatever, yeah, just literally chuck it in, rod straight on the rest, it doesn't matter. Waffling, aren't I? But I do like to sink it when there's a bit of a ripple, Joe. What gang are you in, mate? What do you like to do?
Finn always sinks it.
And I've always sunk my line.
He'll do for me.
But like recently I've seen people who just like chuck it in and put it right on the rest. I'm like, oh. But then I suppose if your feed is heavy enough, you can get away with that, can't
works,
you?
Steve Ringer never sinks his and he catches a few, doesn't he?
He gets the odd one, he does, Joe.
Alright, doesn't he?
Yeah, he doesn't do too. No. Drive by, Joe, drive by. Go on, drive on by. Yeah, drive by. Oh.
Do you know if you're getting a lot of little indications and stuff?
Yeah.
And then it stops. Do you
yeah.
think they've eaten all your bait?
So the thing with it, as I always say when I'm coaching, that the fish, them lines you could be getting could be anywhere from where your line's going in there all the way across. You'd like to think they're around your feeder. So what I always tend to do when I'm getting them is looking. So I know I'm in shallow water there, and if I'm seeing bow waves and that, then yeah, I will bring it back. Obviously from when it stops, when that tip stops moving. But generally, obviously the proper bites, it's usually a few taps as the fish is in your bait, and then it's on, it's round. Or drop backs. You usually get drop backs on places like this, don't you, where you're like chucking right to the far bank. Obviously they can't go that way because they get a headache. So what we are now, we've got 50 seconds left, Joe. Can't believe that's not gone, that one. But again, that's things. Hey up, Joe. Is he on? That's things to pick up on as well. Sometimes they might not be right under that cover where it's dead shallow water. You know, that was sort of like 10 inches off that last one and it's gone round straight away. You know what I mean? They're not always like where you think they'd be. Wild animals, isn't it?
Sometimes off the bank, aren't they?
Yeah. They do like to be. I'm going to come back and give this another chuck, Joe. Getting a lot of indications, but nothing quite there. Well, that's what I mean about these little baby feeders. Got to be busy. That's why I love it. That's why I love this style of fishing, because you're active. It's not like, yeah, you know...
So you're loaded up, ready to go?
Yeah, well, mate, you know, I'm properly prepared now. It's not like you're walloping out there and leaving it sort of like 10, 15, 20 minutes or 3 hours like during the winter. You know what I mean? Just not doing it. And experiment with that bit as well, you know, sometimes... put your bait in first and then put your mix on top of it, so your pellets or whatever you're using is there straight away for the fish. You know, there's no right and wrong with it, is it? It's just what you get used to, I suppose. Yeah, that'll do. It's just what you get used to.
So what ground bait is that?
That is Power Scopex. Mate, I think it's my favourite one in the world. That and the Bonoffi. I love that Bonoffi as well, man. So you can see, another important tip as well is when you've seen, as soon as I've cast it in, I'm not winding to flip my baitline over. I've cast it in, feathered it down, straight onto my rest, which is why my rod's sort of pointing at where I'm fishing, so I've not got any angle in it, so I don't want to don't move the feeder. Baitline over your hand and just let the wind do the job. No winding or anything like that. Then you can just pick your rod up and then you're fishing straight away.
Being as accurate as you can possibly be.
Yeah,
really,
got to be. Yeah, you've got to be. And then just, as I said, this is important as well, having something like that. Just so you can keep an eye on it. So I know at 11:22, I need to bring it back again. Go on, the fishies.
So you catch one more. Obviously, that's the beauty of that ICS, isn't it? Because you can just...
change, that's what I mean. It's like, if we stop getting signs, I can put a bigger feeder on and get straight back on it again. You know what I mean? It's just because before, like, bites were erratic, like, loads of little taps, too many fish there, but it's calmed down now. It's perfect. This is what we want. And usually, you know, your fish are coming within sort of 3 minutes anyway. You know what I mean? That's usually when you're getting your bites on the method. It's quite often a pattern to it, isn't it, Joe? Mm. Feeder fishing. Oh, hey up, hey up. I reckon he's on. He's not on. Nope. Oh, he might be. Might be on him, Joe. No, he's not. No, is he? No. I don't know. Might be a little babby one.
He's having a think about it, isn't he?
Imagine if a carp's just coming in like... in one! Just nailed the whole lot in one. Go on then. What are we on? Oh, we're on 22, Joe. I need to think about bringing that up. Hey, up. Is he? He's not, you know. I thought it was a drive-by. Come on, we've got to finish on a fish, Joe. Right, I'm going to put my bait in different this time. And put that in first, and I'll put...
So you're getting it close to the top?
Yeah.
Nice.
I'll press down. Little puppy one over the top. Ding! Right, come on, the fishes.
I'll show you the technique.
You know what I mean? So we're not moving that rod back or anything like that. Baitline on with your hand, straight over your rest. That's it, rod straight up, onto your rest, and away you go. Nice and quick, fishing. That's what we're on, 22, it's 25.
It's a lovely way to fish, isn't it?
Oh, I love it.
Especially when it starts going.
When it's going, especially when you start getting carp up, hey up. Start getting the carp as well. So this is another thing to pick up on. Obviously, we're getting lots of liners. Last three chucks we've had liners, so it may be that the fish are shorter. You know what I mean? Because obviously we had that one when I did chuck a bit shorter by accident because you were in the way. It went straight away, didn't it? Fuck, let's do it, John. The next one, I'm going to chuck 12 inches shorter. Yeah. I am, mate, actually.
I'm going to do it.
Because to me, them last three chucks that I've had, where I've been right in the teen of turnips, they should have gone, mate, shouldn't they? They just should have gone, Joe, but they've not. So that's telling me that the fish are a little bit shorter.
It's only the same as pole fishing, isn't it? Sometimes I don't want to go right in the shallow water, don't I?
No, you just fish shallow, mate.
Yeah, that's
just fish shallow, isn't
Pace
it?
Pace shallow,
mate. I like that. Come on. Hey, up. There's a lot of carp in that corner, Joe.
There isn't there. Wind blowing in.
Where the Mua hen is.
That's where Jamie would draw, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, definitely. 100% he'd be on
We'd
that.
We'd be up there, where there's no wind. I reckon that would duck.
Come on. Yeah, they're definitely shorter.
So what are you going to reclip up, or are you going to just...
No, what I'm going to do, I'm going to stop it, sort of lock my arm at 12 o'clock and then lower it in so it's coming. So at the minute, I'm locking it at 12, hitting a clip and lowering it down. But this next one, I'm going to lock it at 12 and not bring it down as far so it plops a little bit shy of the of the grass.
So you don't have to do a dish clip or anything?
No.
Doing it,
no, just not, mate, I'm just not doing it. It's been moving all the time since we've been in. So I'm going to do it now, John. I'm just going to do it. See what I mean? See that tail come out then? That was like 2 foot shorter. Right, I'm going to do it. Not prepared though, mate. Not done this, have I?
Straight in the mould.
Just see my big thumb come over it. There we go.
So, I'm interested to see how you're going to do this. Are you stopping it a bit short?
Yeah, so I'm just going to lock my rod at 12 o'clock and then just bring it in a bit shorter like that, yeah? So I've got...
So that was a good couple of foot off the bank, wasn't it?
Yeah. I reckon it's going to go there, though.
I do.
Again, same kind of line, but just stop it a little bit shorter. Because otherwise, you know, if you're taking clips off and all that, and but you need to take them a bit further over, just need to bother with all that again, don't you? Come on. Yay! That was a proper bite, that, wasn't it?
I was going to go straight away.
That was definitely a proper bite, that.
Has that mugged you off, that fish?
I reckon, yeah. That was definitely a... Wasn't it?
Wasn't a drive-by, that was it?
That was not. That, Joe, that was no drive-by. Do you know what I mean? That's in one, isn't it?
So that's angling for you, isn't it?
That's it. It's like reading what's going on. So, like, the likes of Bagger and Jamie and Steve and Lee and Des, they'd have been on that about half an hour ago. Caught one short, I'm going to chuck there again. And they'll just keep going round, whereas I'm like, I want to get tied to the bank. It's nuts, so, isn't it? You know what I mean? That's what, like, that's what it's going to be like in fishing. Just got to read what's going on.
Yeah, the problem, aren't they? They like deep water, don't they?
Yeah. Yep. Club Babby one. So there you go. The new little babby mini method feeders. Amazing.
So if you've enjoyed this video and want to see plenty more like this, don't forget to subscribe to the Preston Innovations YouTube channel. Completely free, and it's bound to put more fish in your net.